people will rush right by and not catch it. But the artwork stops you. And then you stop long enough to see a life that's significant. And if you're willing to dig in and understand what's going on, you'll not be the same. I can tell you that you will not be the same.
I'm Monsignor Peter Ruthier. I'm happy to welcome you to Blessed Sacrament Parish in beautiful Stowe, Vermont, the church whose outside walls tell the story of Father Damien, Sister Marianne Cope, and Brother Joseph Dutton, who went to work at Molokai with Father Damien, who is now Saint Father Damien. Brother Joseph Dutton was born on this property, and therefore, when I come here every day, I give thanks for the blessings of being here in this beautiful village of Stowe, in this beautiful Church of Blessed Sacrament, having Brother Joseph Dutton to watch over me and intercede for me, as I'm sure he does for all who worship here, to give thanks for the community when we gather in prayer together, and to love God by the love we show our neighbor.
I'm Father Damien. I'm a leper.
I know. I'm Brother Joseph Dutton, here to do whatever you want me to do.
Brother Dutton's life of service, his sacrifice to commit so many years of his life to helping others, is something that's important to remember. And people that come to the church and view the murals receive this message. Many of them had, while I was doing the first restoration, many of them had questions about Brother Dutton's life and what the meaning was, particularly of the facade of the church, you know, where the message comes together, comes to fruition, and an invitation is sent forth from the past through the years to the present. These murals on the exterior of the church make you walk all the way around, and the culmination of the story that Gerard narrates through his paintings is found on the front of the church. As you look up at the pediment and down to the doors of the church, there is one overwhelming image that Gerard presents, and that is, as you start at the top, you see at the bottom of the pediment, the lepers looking up to Brother Dutton and Father Damien for guidance. And they in turn look up to the heavens, where a beautiful image of a dove symbolizing the Holy Spirit brings them to union with God.
Understanding of Brother Dutton changed drastically as I did the artwork. Why the church is here, the influence of the church on the community and the world as a whole.
So you really did start making your own transformation yourself.
Yeah, I would definitely say that I came in not expecting to have a transformation. The artwork always to me, I skied in Stowe as a kid. You drive by, see the church and go, okay, it's kind of weird, but okay. The artwork never was really appealing to me, and so I was not drawn to it particularly, but that is because that's normal. People aren't drawn to it generally because it is very stark. Andre Gerard, as I found out, intended it to be stark and less than gravitating to look at, because he did not want to lie through painting to glorify something that was horrifying in Molokai. And he depicted very accurately the horrible conditions in Molokai that Father Damien and Brother Dutton contended with on a regular basis, day to day. So to me, to see that and understand the artwork was actually to go past the artwork to understand what Father Damien and Brother Dutton actually did in their life. And I feel the artwork is a beautiful example of the sacrifice.
Brother Dutton's message is eternal. Each time and place has things that they consider meaningful and special, things that they want to pass to future generations. This is therefore part of history, but it's what we call heritage. And Brother Dutton's message in Hawaii and in Stowe, Vermont is something that is part of a heritage of a people. This church has been supportive of his work for three generations at this point. And the message is still significant and important enough for them to have done so many restorations to keep this message alive. This is something that they want to pass on to future generations.
Very generous.
Why generous? Why is it generous?
To give up his time for, he could be doing anything, and he gives up his time to help people in need.
What somebody like Brother Dutton did was to lay down a groundwork for those who were willing to see a way to live life that is glorifying to God. He exemplifies to me what Christ says, when you do this to the least of these, you do it unto me. So yes, he was doing it to those who could not help themselves, the least of these. But that's what Jesus called us to do. To do it to the least of these is to do it to Christ himself. His love for Christ was exemplified in his life for the least of these.
Everyone who comes here, visitors or parishioners, there's a real sense of God's presence, of his spirit alive, of a willingness to be together as a community and as a family, taking care of one another. That's a legacy that comes from the man that was born on this property.
This entire church was dedicated to him. Very few people have had a church dedicated to them that haven't been canonized.
And it is now felt after all these years, because Joseph Dutton has been dead for some years, that he also had the virtues of great service, commitment to those in need, especially to the sick, that he is worthy of veneration, the first step in the process for beatification and canonization. Having completed an 8-year restoration project, not only on the beautiful windows of the church, but equally on the art panels on the outside, it is time to now work on making him known even more again, of truly that example of service, of giving, of doing so to those most in need.
So, yes, we're committed to coming. And the other thing is, we haven't put the details, but to do some type of video film that we could bring to show.
Oh, my goodness, this is wonderful. I'm glad I turned off the car.
Amen.
Amen. That's perfect.